Okay, that'll do. I'll wear the life jacket of shame, as it were.
I don't mind.
There it is, right there.
I totally forgot.
Rock that bad boy.
Oh, man. It's going to be great.
They can't hear you when you're that far away.
And please don't say that loud.
You can scream it if you want, dude. Tell the world about us.
He doesn't go down the boat. So cool!
It's the Blue Angels practicing. Point, we've been in the Bay Area for quite a while now, living on and working on RadMed. We feel like we've learned so much, like we've become so in tune with the boat and learned how she sails. It's just been great. Great for our spirit, great for our sailing skills, and making sure we had no vehicle available to us to just drive us to a store just for basic things like shopping only steepened our learning curve. We've been in some pretty gnarly blows in the Bay Area. We've had to deal with situations we didn't see coming, and we've also tested our skills and sailed out of, you know, anchorages that were pretty packed or even had, you know, a lot of obstacles, swimmers, bogs, lee shores that were close by. We've started to figure out the Bay Area from the perspective of liveaboard sailors. We've learned how to provision, how to do it cheap, where to do it, and how to do it all sailing to the grocery store.
Supermarket is huge.
And we've had a great time doing it all. But this life that Christina and I chose for us, and the experience that we chose for our kids, it hasn't come without its challenges. If you can't tell from the videos, we're a blended family, and we've definitely had some battles to fight to give them this experience. And the way it's affected them all is profound. The way they've changed and grown, how mature they are for their ages, it's just an amazing thing to see. We're going to keep fighting to be able to include them in this and to include them in our future voyages. We see distant shores right around the corner. We just need to keep our chins down and keep pushing. We'll make it there. Where are we going today?
We are going to Berkeley. As we found out, Chase the Story posted a thing on their Facebook that they're in San Francisco and they're having a seminar question and answer thing. I'm not really sure, but it sounds like fun. So yeah, we're gonna go watch that and then have cocktails afterwards.
And we have no kids.
Yeah, we have no kids. How can we say no?
We follow some of the other sailing families and couples and stuff like that on YouTube here and there. And of all of them, Chase the Story is our favorite so far. The video editing's really good. You know, they take time doing it. And they also, you know, they get good shots with their camera. So it'll be fun to meet them. Hopefully we can ask them some questions about, you know, editing and their process. And what kind of cameras they use and that kind of thing. So, looking forward to it. And this time of year, here in San Francisco Bay, we have learned You want to keep a reef in your main. It's April right now, but it'll just start blowing like crazy out here with pretty much zero warning since we're cruisers and not racers. I'm worried about going real fast. There's no one out here to race. There's only people out here sailing right now. It's pretty typical. Where's the martinis at?
I knew I forgot some.
Damn it.
Oh, they're in Berkeley. I
forgot martinis. Oh, yeah. That's where they are. Okay. All right, pull up the jib. Let's go. I remember the last time you had a martini.
Okay.
We were hanging out with Ashley and what's his name?
That's the problem with martinis.
Well, usually, you know, martini's not a big deal. Just, you should only drink yours and not finish everyone else's too. You want to tell us the story? I'll tell a story. She was incapacitated in a casino bathroom. On the floor. It was great.
What the hell was that?
I just saw a freaking whale. Oh, there it is! Right there!
Oh, yeah.
Alright. Yeah, I saw it blowing. We're going straight towards it. Bug's hat blew off. Hat rescue mission. Successful.
Dude, thank you so much.
Yeah, man. Closer a little bit if you can. There we go. It was our first time coming into Berkeley Yacht Club. It's pretty smooth.
Help, help.
Okay. This wasn't our first rodeo, if you know what I mean. This is how it happens on RadMed. Our viewers want to know.
Yeah, there's actually showers right out there. I don't know. We're I don't want to get either. Out of my comfort zone.
They're inside the Berkeley Yacht Club.
And you have to ring a bell.
You got to ring a bell to go in, and you know we're not members, and well, we don't want to seem like a.
We're members. We're other people's
members. Yeah, we're members with a different club, but we don't want to seem like. Those people that are intruding, you know. If they had more of a more publicly available shower, we'd use it. But this is how it gets done. Most of the time. Mm-hmm. Right in the salon. Because our head is tiny. There's no leg shaving going on in there. Do you wish you had a big mirror, honey?
I do.
Okay.
This one's better than my last one, though.
It's like a tiny little broken, like, 1.5-inch piece.
It was a shard.
Hey, Daddy, how do I look?
Oh, it is humanity.
Pants. We had some time to burn, so we checked out some of the old boats, kicking it around the marina. A little bit of rot in the deck on that one. And we spotted a sister to Rad Mode, the Constanza, a pretty pimped out West Sail 32.
everybody. Welcome. Thank you for coming. My name is Phil. Tasha, take over. So let's give everybody, give Tasha a big round of applause.
All right.
We bought it with a friend of ours. Ryan kind of got a good friend drunk in the bar and convinced him to go in on half the boat with us. So, and the bar was in Tribeca. It was called Hideaway.
Yeah.
Oh, double, oh, double. Double. She didn't double. Did the double, right?
Quick draw too.
Okay.
Oh, perfect. Like, right.
I lose my wallet all the time.
Oh, you've got a GoPro. Oh, you got the new one?
No.
Oh. Because it looks different.
To figuring out how to do it even though we don't know what the fuck we're doing.
And I think that's the best way
and
to
having good
it. Cheers.
We met some good people that night.
That was fun, huh?
Yeah.
Oh. Now we're freezing cold.
It's so cold.
We got booze?
Yeah.
Let's drink and warm us up. Think I can jump that chain? Oh yeah, easy.
Since the city wasn't too far from the marina, we decided to attempt a provisioning run the very next day.
Miss that at all.
And here's the point where we should have turned around, but didn't.
One of the guys under that overpass started yelling at us. Not sure what he was saying, but just kept walking. Kind of ghetto. Try and find a different way back. Do that thought. You know, everyone's scared about other countries possibly getting, you know, attacked or robbed or something like that. And we're more worried about it in America. I think we got a good learning experience from this, and what we need to be doing is asking locals a little bit more. If we walk this way, are we going to run into any weird stuff, any challenges, troubles, that kind of thing? So we should start doing that more. Someone at the marina might have been able to tell us that we should not have gone under that overpass.
What about Noah? She told me you told her.
You know, lesson learned.
Let's go over the overpass.
Huh?
Let's go over it.
Walk over it?
All right.
All right. We've decided we're going to risk death to avoid risking death, right? So, yeah, we're not going to risk going back under the thing and dealing with those guys down there. It's not worth it to us.
Instead,
we're going to walk over the overpass, and there's no sidewalk. Almost back to the marina, and we didn't even have to get raped. Worked out pretty good, our plan. Thanks for watching that episode, and I hope if you made it this far that you liked it. And if you did, please hit that like button down below, give us a thumbs up, and share it with anybody you know that would be interested in watching it. Also, subscribe to our channel if you haven't and you're interested in following along with more of our adventures. And speaking of adventures, right now we are in the location of our 2017 birthday bash, which is a hell of a party. We've been tearing it up and I got some great stuff on film. But a couple quick other notes before I let you guys go, and you can sign off now if you want. But, you know, the guy that organized the Chase the Story event at OCSC Sailing School, his name's Phil. Super cool dude, really squared away, and did a great job managing that event, in my opinion. So if you're looking to set up some kind of an event at a sailing school, that he would be a good person to call. And he's in the next episode. He takes us sailing on a race boat, like kind of a pretty pimped out Catalina 38. Tasha was super cool also, and she's the same person she is in the videos, which is always cool to see. I learned some stuff from her about video editing and her video editing process, which is cool and has helped me out a bit. But she's a great public speaker. If you get a chance to see her, check her out. She was hilarious. And the last thing I want to mention is when we went under the overpass in the video there, okay, I didn't really play it down later because I don't usually get my blood pumped up from stuff like that, but it was really dangerous. It was dangerous for us to have gone down through there. There were two dozen guys standing around, one of which started yelling, screaming, and cussing at me with a half-empty 40, and he was all tatted out in prison. I couldn't even understand what he was saying. He was so trashed already. This was probably 10 in the morning. You know, but I should have listened to that little voice in the back of my head. If you've read Gift of Fear by Gavin DeBecker, then you'll know I did the wrong thing at that point in time. And I know better. But yeah, we came out of it okay. And you know, it's always better to just remove yourself from a situation, we think, than to put yourself in more danger by trying to be a tough guy or something like that. But that's it. Thanks a lot for watching. We love you guys. See you in the next episode.